Definitely, yeah. Other people should try. I would say that anyone who has an interest in the outdoors should give it a try. I mean, as long as you are able to sleep in a tent, to know what it is to sleep in a tent, you know, the light canvas, the no noise proofing at all, the sense of openness to the elements that you get even in the best tents. If you're okay with that, if you can live without your bed and you create your comfort, give it a try. I mean, you might not want to buy anything at all. You might have a mate who has got the kit or a mate who's going out, who's got a mate who's not going out. Just borrow the kit for the night. When I first started reading about it, it always sounded a bit like an adventure, and an adventure for people who only had the right gear and the kind of right attitude, and I wouldn't say we're daredevils, but we're not too afraid of losing themselves in some desolate moorlands. And it was a bit intimidating. Especially as I had no particular experience of camping either. So it was fascinating to read. I mean, you could read the stories by some of the regulars on the forums or on the blogs about how they spend the night somewhere somewhere high when it was really cold. And it gives you a desire to try if you got this interest in the outdoors, really. I guess some people will never relate to it because they like the comfort. And, I enjoy my comfort, my B&B, my roaring fires, my ale on tap and all that. But the idea of basically living by your own means up there, you know, packing everything in your little bag, find yourself a spot and just get along with whatever the weather throws at you and whatever the conditions are, was quite fascinating. Army copter. Not only did I find a cheaper tent, but bit by bit you can buy some lighter equipment compared to what you need to go when you go camping with a car on a campsite. And again, there's no need to pay an absolute fortune. I got a bag from Tesco, a sleeping bag from Tesco. It does the job. If it's not too cold, and it cost me £37. I mean, it really dispels this notion that that everything is expensive when you go wild camping. It need not to be. Obviously, the more money you put in, and the lighter and better your equipment will be. And I'll probably need to invest a bit more money for winter. The conditions are a bit more different. But for summer wild camping, you really do not need to spend that much money. Wild camping, why do wild camping? It's just fun, really. I mean, there is no great mystique about it, I would say. It's just you and a bunch of lads going up the moors, have a nice walk, and then set up camp in the full knowledge that it's very unlikely you'll have anyone else around you. Therefore, you can be as foolish as you want, and some people have been quite foolish of what I've seen. And you just sit yourself down and have a drink, have a giggle, have a chat. Or if you're on your own, you just lie there and enjoy the silence.
What's fascinating about wild camping is that it's a way for you to expand your day, your time out in the hills. On a day walk, you're limited by time constraints, transport constraints. You just go up there, you do your walk, and then you have to go back down. Sometimes you need to be wary of daylight. A bit longer and a bit without stress, you cook yourself your tea, you look at the sun going down, you sit down, have a drink, and just relax, really. That's the great bonus of being able to wild camp, is that it gives you a freedom of carry on what is essentially a great experience a bit longer, and it is that little bit better for you, for your soul, and indeed for your body, as the more exercise you do, the better you feel.